हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट द सी इंस्ट्रक्शंस। देर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ सी इंस्ट्रक्शंस। फर्स्ट वन इज टाइप डिक्लेरेशन इंस्ट्रक्शंस, सेकंड इज अर्थमेटिक इंस्ट्रक्शन एंड थर्ड वन इज कंट्रोल इंस्ट्रक्शंस। इन द टाइप डिक्लेरेशन इंस्ट्रक्शंस, दीज टाइप ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शंस आर यूज टू डिक्लेयर द टाइप ऑफ वेरिएबल्स यूज इन ए C program. In the arithmetic instructions, these type of instructions are used to perform the arithmetic operations between constants and variables. And the control type of instructions are used to control the sequence of execution of various statements in a C program. Let's see what is the type declaration instruction. Type declaration instruction is used to declare the type of the variables. As we have studied the integers, we have studied float variables, we have studied character variables. To declare these type of data types, we use the type declaration instructions. Here we can see, if we want to declare integer, we will firstly write the int and after that the variable name and use the semicolon. This semicolon is must. If we want to declare the float type of instructions, we will write float. After that, we will write the variable name. It can be one or more than one. And after that, we have to use the semicolon. Likewise, in the case of the character type of data type, we have to firstly write the char and after that the variable names, and after that we will use the semicolon. One most important thing to note is that we can declare number of variables in the same statement, and we can define the variable here also. Like here we can see I is assigned the value 10 and j is assigned the value 25. Likewise, in this example float, after that we have given the value a 1.5, b is written here in the form of the expression where b is equal to 1.99 plus 2.4 and multiplication 1.44. After that we here use the semicolon. Even we can use here expression also, but here we have to note that we must declare the variable used in this expression firstly here. If we write it later, like in this example, if we firstly write b and after that a, and a is used in the first declaration, it will be wrong. There will be error that a is not defined. Likewise, we can declare integer a, b, c, d. A number of variables can be declared here. One point also to note here that if we want to declare int type and we say a is equal to b is equal to c is equal to 10, then we must use the semicolon here. In this statement is right and this statement is wrong. We can't give here the equal signs for these variables. And this type of declaration statements came after this main function. After that we have to sign here of the braces and declare the data types. Second type of instructions are the arithmetic instructions. Arithmetic instructions use the variable name on the left hand side and equal sign and variable names and constant on the right hand side of the equal sign. Like we can use दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द अर्थमेटिक इंस्ट्रक्शंस. वी कैन सी दैट इंटीजर एडी फ्लोट इज कोट डेटा एल्फा बीटा गामा एंड एडी इज इक्वल टू 3200. हियर वी कैन नोट दैट मल्टीप्लीकेशन साइन डिविजन साइन सब्ट्रैक्शन साइन एंड एडिशन साइन आर द अर्थमेटिक ऑपरेटर्स. दिस इज द असाइनमेंट ऑपरेटर. 2, 5, 30, 200 आर द इंटीजर कॉन्स्टेंट्स which can be assigned to these values, and these are the real constants, and these can be assigned to the float values. AD is an integer variable, and cot, data, alpha, beta, gamma are the real variables. This is the hierarchy of the operations. How the arithmetic operators can be used. If we have the multiplication sign in some expression, so it will be given the priority, first priority. Multiplication, division and modulus operator. This is called the modular division. This gives the remainder, and this division sign will give the quotient, and this will give the multiplication. Second priority is given to the addition and the subtraction. Third priority is for the assignment. Here is a tricky question. Minus 5 modulus 2 will give the minus 1. Whereas if we divide 5 by the minus 2, then remainder will be 1. So here are some examples for the algebraic expressions. We write in mathematics like these, but when we have to write these expressions in the C language, then we will write these expressions like these. We will use a star for this multiplication sign. Here also it will be, and minus is same. In the second example we can see, in mathematics we write these expression like this, but in C we will use some multiplication sign here, star. Likewise, if we have to write 3x square, this is the square, 3x square. So we will write it like 3, after that multiplication sign, it is x variable, this is again multiplication sign and x. After that we will write the plus, same as in the mathematics, and we'll write the 2x like 2 into x. This plus sign is again same, and 5 is again. So if we want to write this expression in C, firstly we will take parenthesis, we'll write A plus B plus C, again parenthesis close. For the division we will use the division sign, we will again take the parenthesis, we'll give the expression D plus E and parenthesis close. Likewise, if we want to write this type of mathematical expression in C, we will write 2by, same in the above example we see, 2 into b into y. We have to insert this symbol. For the division, we will write this sign, and after that for this expression we will use the parentheses like here used. These, after writing these, we will write this minus, here this minus is x is this, and for division we will use the division sign, and we'll write the denominator like 3 दिस एक्चुअली दिस इज इन द कॉन्टिन्यूएशन बट ड्यू टू द शॉर्टेज ऑफ द स्पेस आई राइट इट हेयर बट यू कैन राइट इट इन कॉन्टिन्यूएशन थ्री एंड फॉर दिस मल्टीप्लीकेशन वी हैव टू यूज दिस साइन एंड दिस एक्सप्रेशन इज सेम. थर्ड टाइप ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन आर दी कंट्रोल इंस्ट्रक्शन. As the name suggests, control instructions enables us to specify the order in which the various instructions in a program are to be executed by the computer. In other words, control instructions determine the flow of the control in a program. There are four types of control instructions in C. First one is sequence control instructions. Second is selection or decision control instructions. Third is repetition or loop control instructions. And fourth is case control instructions. So in the first case, if we are writing a number of statements and we want to jump from these to this line, so the sequence of the instruction will be changed from the one to directly fifth line. So these instructions help to take from the 1 to 5th statements directly. In the second case, selection or the decision control, if we want to take some decision, like if we write 3 is less than 5, if 3 is less than 5, and as we know that 3 is less than 5 is true, so we can write in the program, if this condition comes true, the program will go to the this statement, and if this statement is false, then we want to jump to the this instruction. So this decision or selection will be done by the selection and the decision control instruction. In the third type of repetition or loop control instruction, if we have a number of instructions and we want that these instructions come more than one time in the same program and we want to do these steps repeatedly, so we use these type of instructions and the cursor will come to again to first statement. After completing these, it will again come to the first statement as many times as programmer need. In the third type of case control instructions, we can switch it to the particular case as required by the user. So this type of four instructions we will discuss in detail in further videos. Summary of the today's video which we have done. First thing we come to know that there are three primary constants and variable types in C. First is integer, second is float, third is character. Second point is a variable name can be maximum of the 31 characters. It can't exceed, but it depends upon the compiler type. In Turbo C, we have the restriction of the 31 characters. Third is, do not use the keyword. As we have discussed, there are 32 keywords. We can't use these 32 keywords as a variable name. Fourth is, an expression may contain any sequence of constants, variables, and operators. Fifth is, operators having equal precedence are evaluated using the associativity. Means which type of, if we have multiply, division and modular in the first priority and having expression, having these at the first number or addition in the second number, then we have to firstly calculate the associativity of the expression. Sixth point is, left to right associativity means the left operand of a operator must be unambiguous, whereas right to left associativity means the right operand of the operator must be unambiguous. So it depends upon the expression. If in some expression right associativity occurs, so we have to take that. Last point is input output in C can be achieved using scanf and printf functions. Thank you for watching this video. So we will discuss these three these four type of instructions in further videos. Thank you for watching.